So how is the character coping in the new world of 2000s?
You know, like, I'm really happy to... It was a surprise that Echo loved space so much, because to me she was such an earthy person, and she did well in the forest. It's like, she's, you know, a warrior, and they're very visceral people, and so being in space I thought was going to be a departure, like a tough time for her. But she actually enjoyed it, because she was like, this is relaxing. There's no weird bears with two heads, et cetera, et cetera. But so I think she has a confidence going into the new world that she'll be able to handle it. But I think she's surprised at the ways in which she gets disarmed by it, which is always fun to play as the actor, you know, the surprise threats that you don't see come.
So how long is it in this new world before Echo finds herself in some drama?
Pretty immediately. Like, maybe right away. Like, episode 2.
Episode 2 is, yes, like a nice,
it's like
break.
It's, yeah, like, it's like coming in hot. Pardon me?
Well, I mean, you get to relax through all of episode 1. That's nice.
I was on the swing set. I watched Murphy do a fantastic air band rendition of whatever, you know, and that was a fun day at work too. I was just like, this is the best day. But yeah, right away you saw how episode the premiere finished, so yeah, things happened pretty quickly to the rest of us too,
because we obviously see, you know, Bellamy and Echo get a lot closer in the previous season. How good is their relationship and, you know, going into the new season, and is that going to be tested fairly quickly?
I think, like, they balance each other really well. I think, you know, Echo's whole thing is she's very no drama. She's, like, all about getting to the point and being very, you know, objective and oriented on the goal at hand. And also, she doesn't know everybody very much either, so she does, you know, she's more of, like, the watchful passenger. But they do have their first fight on screen, so that was fun to do with Bob.
Like a physical fight?
No, no, we actually had that in season 4. Yeah. I flipped him on his back, which is also fun. But yeah, no, they do good. You know, they balance each other out, but there is some tension that happens this season. So, yeah.
Did Bob direct you in his episode?
Sure did.
How'd he do?
I told him I was going to give him a tough time. I said, Bob, I'm going to be a little brat on set, is what I'm going to be. He's like, great. No, he did a great job. I mean, it was really, I'm sure you've heard this already today, he just took to directing so naturally. It was amazing to watch. Like, he was, and it brought him a joy when he was at, like, he's always, like, joyful and fun at work and stuff like that, but he was just, you know, discovering this new kind of side of him, and he's really good at directing, so it was really great.
Would you want to direct?
It's something that I've thought about, and I would, but I will process that later. Like, I'm happy being behind, you know, as an actress.
But you watch when you're on set.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
A lot of actors don't. They're in their room.
Yeah.
You know, and fine, you know, but they're making a show, and you can, like, learn so much.
1,000%. Like, you know, what I typically do is you can go sit in the cast chairs and have a hangout or just, like, a moment to decompress from what you're filming. And it depends on the day, how stressful the day is, whether you need that or not. But Eliza is actually really good at this. Like, when they're like, okay, this is your 15-minute warning, she'll stand up and kind of walk towards, like, the set, you know, and she'll just do that for herself. And she's quiet, but those are the moments, the 15 minutes before we start filming are the most important, because you get a sense of, you can see what they've framed up, I think you can see the lighting. Hi, boo-boo.
Aww.
I miss you. So cute. And, and you can get a sensibility about the camera lenses and the sizes and the energy and what's about to happen and stuff like that. So that's something that I've started adopting too, you know, in the last, like,
half. It's like an official shadow.
Yeah. And it's good to be aware.
Of course.
You know, you work on other projects with different people, and people aren't aware of how things are getting filmed or lenses or whatnot. You know, those little, like, things that you should learn on set. But when you quietly go and observe, gives you so much information, so
and this is the start of book two as well. So does it feel like a new show going into it, or does it very much feel like the same?
Feels like a completely different. You know what? This was like the beauty of the season is it felt totally different as an actor walking into the space. And I remember, like, I turned around and I looked at everybody and I was like, this is just, like, visually and the colors and everything were so different. And yet, in such an interesting way, like, there's woven in all of the themes and the ideas and symbols of the previous seasons. Hi, Jason.
Spoiler, please.
You guys are my...
casual walk of it. Yes, 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 thank you.
And I was wondering as well with Maddie now as a commander and Maddie Clark relationship, how's that going to
end? That's something that I've processed a lot, you know, like is Echo's understanding of spirituality and technology, because she was very, very committed to the Ezgeta theology.
Yeah.
And then she lived in space. So I was like, where does that land her? You know, when she got explained all the things that have gone on over the last little, you know, 6 years or whatnot. And I think that I think she's agnostic. I think that she's processing that for herself, but I do think that she does have an undeniable commitment to Maddie, that she just can't, you know, following the commander is a part of her fabric, and she's still learning so much too, which is so interesting because she's so capable. So it's an interesting thing to play as, like, someone who's, like, learning all these new things and someone who's also very capable, physically capable human.
And will she go against Clark? So, you know, sometimes Clark will do things that Maddie doesn't want to do in a protective, motherly way. Is Echo going to be there on Maddie's side?
That's a difficult one to answer. I don't know how to answer that clearly.
We've lost so many characters over the seasons. Are there any that were close to your heart that you miss?
Of course. Oh my God. I was devastated. I mean, like, every season you get devastated, which is kind of the fun of the 102. Mm-hmm. It's like the surprising, like, oh, wow. You know, the losses of the show. But, I mean, I miss characters, but they've become friends. So, like, as the actor, I'll miss certain energies on set. Like, I miss Rowan, and I miss Nadia. I miss, you know, Luna. And I miss Chelsea and Chris and stuff like that. But.
And you've obviously got, like, essentially 400 potential characters in the cryopods.
Oh, yeah.
So how we know that initially you've got kind of a landing crew, and then you're going to see more.
Mm-hmm.
How long does it take for us to kind of see everybody... wake up those pods.
I know, I'm like, there were people that were there for longer than I had anticipated. At the end of the season, I remember being like, thank God you're out, you know, like, we needed you, we missed you. But you know, there's people that show up kind of in the middle that are integral to the story.
And the trailer looked, like, beautiful, and the new world looks really neat. And is there any particular sort of set or part of that that you really enjoyed? Because, you know, we tend to see you guys all, like, in the mud fighting kind of a bit more, and now you look like you've got a kind of a home, really.
Is there any part of the trailer that I...
Any part of that set?
Oh my gosh, the whole set is amazing. Like, when the writers, like, for their episode, they'll fly down the writer, you know? So it was like every time there was a new episode, I would remember being like, have you seen the set yet? You know, like, come, welcome. And everything was just so visually stimulating. And there is this one, like, party scene in the trailer that looks like a little bit of a disco party. But that was, like, such a fun day to shoot. Like, all of us were like, where are we? What is happening? And, yeah, that was really fun.
I think it must be the first time I've been clubbing in, like...
Oh, 1,000%. Echo was like... Wow!
So send the writer down when the episode's being shot or before so they get ideas on how to write it?
No, when.
When, so they get to, that's cool for the writer.
Yeah.
They get to see it shot.
Yeah. Yeah. We need them there to, you know, to help us.
Right.
Yeah.
The truth.
Yeah.
And I wanted to know as well, like, with the Allegia Sport crew as well coming in, we know, like, you're going to have those new characters as well. Are you going to be interacting much with them? Because we pretty much saw you with Space Crew last season. You didn't get that much chance to play with the others.
I know. I want to play with the others. Yeah. Give me the others.
Will you get a chance?
Yes, I will. Yeah. And then there's, like, a whole bunch of other stuff that, you know, we haven't even danced on yet in terms of the trailer and whatnot that other friends I play with too. New friends.